But we're down here at Bower Pond and we're taking a stroll, and there's quite a difference in the winter time than now. And, the temperature is about 24 degrees. My dog is panting heat.
Well, guys, we went all this way for
about a mile out and picking up stuff that she shouldn't be picking up. She's like a quit eating that. She's like a pocket picker, shoplifter. And like I said, it's pretty warm here. Nice people. How you doing?
Good, and yourself?
Pretty good. And the boulders are out there as well, and you know, the little paddle boats, they'll be fun to get on. But anyways, it's all in fun. People are enjoying it. Mabel, well, she's enjoying the heat and the sunshine and whatever else she may be liking to do. She just did her mess up above, so. But you got to keep an eye on this girl too, because she's got a habit of picking up stuff off the ground if you're not careful, such as balls and sticks. Well, we'll let you go for now, and I don't want my friend to walk in against somebody's bike. It might have a tire up the rear end, and somebody will definitely have a parking space for their bike. Well, we made it so far down to this area, and we're about to go to the Conqueror's House, I believe it's called. Conquest, pardon me for living. Go ahead, girl.
Okay, thank you.
I don't mind. But then after that, we're going to see the CP Rail Bridge Trestle, I believe it's called.
Are you enjoying your walk at Bower Ponds?
Mabel, answer that question. Woo! Mabel, you enjoying your walk? You enjoying your walk, baby? Yes, you are. She's laying down. She's all overheated here. Yep. So, hey, baby, go and take daddy for a walk. Ooh, nice girl. Here comes, guess who's on candid camera?
Well, I'm not too sure what to say. You know, I've been an actor for many years. John Wayne and the rest of the big crew.
Now, this house was actually removed from across the river from another location and relocated here at the park. But in the process of doing so, they must have removed all the brickwork that was on the house itself by taking it off so that it wouldn't be damaged in the move. Now, each brick has been counted for and then put back on. While doing so, the house itself was probably transported by a barge, and then from there on was also transported by tractor trailer. Since it was back in the 1980s, it was pretty easy to do. They would jack up the house and they would back the trailer underneath, or causing the house to go on the trailer. From there on, it was transported here, put on foundation the same way, by leveling it out on blocks, and then from there on they actually would reassemble the windows if they weren't already taken out, and then put the brickwork back in. Come on, Grandma, get an ice cream cone.